Now we'll discuss about gear train. So what is gear train? Gear train means here numbers of gears are connected to each other to transmit motion from one gear to another gear. So we have different types of gear train are there. That is simple gear train, compound gear train, epicyclic gear train. So first we will discuss about simple gear train. In this gear train, all gear are connected to individual shaft. Here in this gear train, we can see three number of gears are meshed with each other. Then all the gears are connected to individual shaft. And here the gear A is the driver gear and gear C is the driven gear. Means the motion of gear A is transmitting to the gear C. And the gear B is the intermediate gear, which is termed as idler. So first we will see the gear ratio or velocity ratio for this gear train. To get the velocity ratio, first we will divide the total train into two parts. That is first part containing gear A and gear B, and second part is containing gear B and gear C. So for gear A and B, that gear A is driver gear and gear B is driven gear. So the gear ratio equal to omega A by omega B. And for the second part, that is gear B is driver gear and gear C is driven gear. So the gear ratio for the second part equal to omega B by omega C. So the gear ratio for the total train or whole mechanism, we will combine these two parts, that is omega A by omega B into omega B by omega C. So omega B is cancel out and finally we got, that is gear ratio equal to omega A by omega C. From this we can conclude that the gear ratio is only depending upon the velocity of driver gear and driven gear. So no such effect will be provided by the idler gear on the velocity ratio. Whatever may be the number of idler are connected to the gear train, the velocity of the idler will never affect the gear ratio. The gear ratio only depend upon the velocity of the driver and driven gear. So why this idler or B is used? So the idler gear or gear B is used to change the direction of rotation of the output wheel. So next gear train is compound gear train. In compound gear train, one shaft can also contain more than one number of gear, that is two or more than that also. So in this gear train, what we can see, total numbers of gears are four, that is A, B, C and D, but the number of shafts are three. Means the shaft number one and shaft number three is containing only one gear, that is A and D, but the shaft number two is containing two gears, that is B and C. So now we will discuss about the velocity ratio or gear ratio of this train. So first we will see, we can find out that gear B and gear C have same angular velocity because both are connected to one shaft, and what is the velocity of the shaft, that is equal to the velocity of gear B and velocity of gear C. So omega B equal to omega C. Now we will find out the gear ratio. So here also we will divide it into two parts. So first part containing two gear, that is gear A and gear B, and the second part is containing gear C and gear D. So velocity ratio of first part is equal to omega A by omega B. and velocity ratio or gear ratio of second part equal to, that is omega c by omega t, and the intermediate part is, that is omega b by omega c. But we know that omega b by omega c equal to 1, so the velocity or gear ratio for the total train equal to omega a by omega b into omega b by omega c into omega c by omega d. So omega b and omega c are cancelled out, and finally we got that gear ratio equal to omega a by omega d, which is velocity of angular velocity of driver by driven. So this velocity ratio is also equal to the number of teeth ratio. Means how it will be related? As we know that angular velocity equal omega equal to pi d n. So we can see that is g equal to pi d a n a divided by pi d a n b, and from that we will conclude that g equal to omega a by omega d, which is equal to d a by d b, which is equal to t b by t a, where d is the diameter of the gear and t is the number of teeth of the gear. Our next train is epicyclic gear train. So up to now what we have discussed, those gear train in which axis of wheel remains fixed relative to one another. But there is another system of gear train in which there is relative motion between two or more of the axis of the wheels. Such arrangement of wheel is known as epicyclic gear train. It is also known as a planetary gear train. Epicyclic gear train are also simple as well as compound. Epicyclic gear train are used full for transmitting very high velocity ratio with gear of moderate size. These gear trains upgrade have great practical importance, and we can find out in all the workshop, in all workshop and electrical machine. For example, back gear of lathe are epicyclic gear train, differential gears, gear box of motor vehicles, etc. are the epicyclic gear train. So here we can see the picture of epicyclic gear train or planetary gear train. Here the first gear, that is rotating in its own axis, and the second gear is rotating about the periphery of the first gear, so that it is termed as this planetary gear train also. Our next mode of power transmission is bell drive. Bell drive is generally containing a pair of rolling cylinder with motion of one cylinder being transferred to another cylinder by a belt. The transmitted torque is due to difference in tension that occur in the belt during operation. The different result in a tight side and a slack side. The bell drives may be a open bell drive and a cross bell drive. In most of the application, we can see this bell drive, like in industrial application in power plant to transmit coal from the storage to boiler, we are using bell drive. And also in most of the machines like planer machine, we used bell drive. And in some electrical machines like generator also, we use bell drives. Most of the things where long distance power transmission is required, we use bell drive. So here we can see the two bell drive, first one is cross belt and second one is open belt. Here we can see in first diagram, that is two pulleys are there, that is A and B, which are connected by means of a belt, which is intersecting it at the middle point so that it is a crossed bell drive. And in second diagram we can see generally two pulleys, four pulley, but here we will see two pulleys, that is A and B, where these two are connected by using belt that is not crossing each other. So it is a open belt drive.